These shocking images are from a shop in Auckland's Grey Lynn on Friday night. We don't yet know their ages, but if they are young people, how did we get to this?
The worst of the worst, so, you know, the once warrior stuff.
This is where they're coming from, these kids.
Yep, yep.
In the first part of the series, we went to the youth justice residence Carl Kuiti manages. This is English class, lyric writing, learning to express themselves with words. Almost without exception, these young people come from homes where violence is the defining language.
So how often did you see violence? Regularly?
Like most days, yep.
So these are the most damaged, the most abused, and the most frightened, and the least hopeful about what life has in store for them. And they're attracted to other children and young people who have the same experiences as them.
This is Judge Ida Malosi's domain, the youth court, which doesn't actually have its own premises but sits in our district courtrooms. 20 years since she first sat up here, thousands of hours in the company of damaged and damaging young people.
What do we need to do with these children?
We need to be tough for them, not to them.
That doesn't mean going soft. Ida Malosi's a judge. She sends people out this grimly busy door, puts them behind bars. But that's no victory, she says. The victory is stopping the crime. Then we'll be safer.
And the starting point is to make them safe, so that they have a sense of security, they have a sense of hope, they have a reason to be part of society instead of finding some attraction of sitting outside of it.
Early last month, Ida Malosi became principal youth court judge. This at a time when there are increasing calls to get tough on young offenders.
But what I see in young people, John, is they have the sense, they just have the sense that what they're doing is wrong, but they don't have the ability to do it in the right way unless we give them an opportunity for that.
So that, it would seem to me, would suggest that we need to get to them way, way, way before they're turning up in the youth court, right?
100%. It's not rocket science.
It's important science. Throughout the series, everyone we've spoken to says we'll stop this behaviour when we address what makes young people behave like this, getting tough on the causes of crime before the damage is done.
I often ask myself this, John, who could not feel sad about the plight of those children? Who could not be motivated to do whatever it takes as a nation to make their lives better? Because I just so believe that making their lives better makes our life better. It has to be the case in this land of milk and honey, surely.